What's up, Lakers Nation? I'm Nikki Kay.
And I'm Denise Jones.
And it is game day. The Los Angeles Lakers at 5-6 facing the Sacramento Kings, who surprisingly aren't terrible. They're 7-5 on the season.
Good for them, because early on in our predictions before the season, we didn't think that they were going to be as good as they are. So good for them.
Yeah.
Good for them.
And both teams actually share a common opponent from this past week, and that's the Minnesota Timberwolves, who lost to both the Kings and the Lakers. And now Jimmy Butler's going to the 76ers as of this morning. So crazy stuff.
Which is interesting. I didn't expect that to happen, but we'll see.
Yeah, and talking Kings, like, this team is fast, and we're going to see a track meet tonight. The Kings lead the league in pace. They're fourth in scoring. Meanwhile, we know how much the Lakers love to thrive in the fast break. They lead the NBA in fast break points and are third in scoring. So it's going to be a fun one tonight.
It's definitely going to be a fun one. I feel like the Lakers really have to work on their transition game just because the Kings really have that on lock. I love the fast break that we run.
Yeah.
I feel like when we run a fast break, let's be honest, like, we might not play our best with the best teams, but I feel like when it comes to, like, teams like the Sacramento Kings, I feel like we always deliver. And if we keep the fast break momentum going, when we run a fast break, it's hard for anyone to keep up.
Yeah.
So I feel like work on the transition, definitely work on the defense, great addition with Tyson Chandler, and then just keep the fast break momentum on a high the entire time.
Yeah, and a couple of things the Lakers can take moving forward from their win over Minnesota was playing defense for a full four quarters. LeBron was happy about that after the game. And the rebounding was definitely improved, and that was largely in part to the presence of Tyson Chandler.
Yeah.
They out-rebounded the Wolves, which was great to see, and we talk about Chandler. I mean, he only had 2 points in that game, but his presence was so noticeable. He had 5 offensive boards and basically made key contributions down the stretch to close out the win.
Yeah, it was a great game for Tyson, just because it was, first of all, it was his first game in the purple and gold.
Yeah.
And the fact that he was able to deliver with the minutes that he played in the way that he did was absolutely amazing. It was exactly what the Lakers needed. He kept the energy up on the bench and on the court. So I feel like it's one of those things where the Tyson Chandler signing could open that door to just the weak side when it comes to defense that we need.
Absolutely. And, like, what the Lakers need to do tonight is definitely contain guys like Buddy Hield, De'Aaron Fox, Willie Cauley-Stein. Buddy's shooting, like, over 45% from beyond the arc. De'Aaron Fox is putting himself together a nice little season so far, averaging 18 points a game. We have yet to determine whether Lonzo will be in or out tonight. He had a tweaked ankle.
Yeah.
So that's something to keep an eye on for Lakers Nation fans. And, I mean, talking about the Minnesota win once again, 4 Lakers finished with 20 points. You like that balanced scoring.
Yeah, no, we've definitely been, as far as, like, just keeping that consistency going, I feel like we've worked on it a lot better, especially compared to early on in the season. You mentioned De'Aaron Fox. I feel like he's a big surprise that no one expected him to just kind of step up the way that he did. So it's going to be an interesting game. I'm predicting a W just because it's the Kings, and not to say that they're not a good team, because they've definitely gotten better, but we are the better team when it comes to tonight's game.
Yeah, and the Lakers need to get wins where they can, and this is a big weekend for LA because you've got the Kings tonight, the Hawks tomorrow night, back to back, and you would love to see the starters sitting out minutes in the fourth quarter to get rest and get the job done tomorrow against Trae Young and the Hawks.
Yeah, now I'm excited. I'm definitely excited. I feel like this weekend should be a successful one for LA in both days, but we'll see.
Yeah, we'll see. Tip-off's at 7 p.m. tonight. Let us know what you think. Like, comment, and subscribe. And remember, for everything Lakers, keep it locked
on LakersNation.com.